Okay, the next step is to go on Visual Weld. Right, we open the file and you have to go to the folder. This is Sysweld and MMAW, I think, was the folder. We have the MMAW VDB. Mine is set on all files. You can adjust it on VDB file if there are too many files in your folder. Anyways, here is selected. It is here. Alright, the first thing to do is to adjust the weld path. So we select on welding and we go to the trajectory and we're going to select the path of welding. So the path here is going to be selected. It can be here in the middle, and we need to select the reference. It is always better to select the reference in the corner of the weld, like here. You'll see why in the future. Alright, the element length is 10 millimeter, which means that the length of the weld is 10 millimeter. So if we preview, and by holding A, I can rotate this one, and if I uncheck this gray boundary, we see that the welding is starting from here. So we have this weld here is the final weld. So the weld is start from inside the plane and continues to here, which is the end node. So this is the reference path and this is the path, because we're dealing with 2D. It's like this. When we hit apply, the path is created. It should be inside the part. Here, I believe these are the path. Yeah, and we have different collectors, including the path, reference, starting node, everything else. Alright, before jumping to Welding Advisor, I would like to show you the database of the material we have here. If we click on Database and Material, we see there's a wide variety of materials here in Sysweld software. We have 5000 series aluminum alloys, 6000 series, or we have low alloy carbon steels. This is the steel we're dealing with, ST52, or the other name is S355. Here under CCT, we can draw the CCT diagram, or we can draw the TTT diagram or everything else, which is pretty unique in this software, and you cannot find it in any other software. And also, the phases are here in, if we go to the metallurgy, we see that there are the reactions of the phases, ferrite to austenite, fictive phase to austenite. We can see the mechanical properties like the Young modulus or yield stress. Here is the thermal mechanical properties, and in the generic info you can see different phases. I already have written the phases for you here for convenience, but you can find them here. Phase 1 is ferrite, phase 2 is the filler material, phase 3 is martensite and bainite, and so on. So This was the database of the material, just in case. The next thing to do is to go to the welding advisor. Click on the welding advisor. We are going to select a name for our model, MMAW, and we have to set the working directory. For me, is already been selected. So here we see that the next one, the next step is orange. It means we can go and modify the parameter. And when we go to the number two, it turns blue. It means we are in this section. And first step is green. It means it's done, we don't need to modify that. We're going to have a 2D cross sectional, and we're going to select the material from the database of material. I'm going to select this one, or you can go under low alloy carbon steel and select the material from here, doesn't matter. And we click on component and select the base metal to assign the material to the base metal, and we click add. See that the base metal is selected and the material is assigned to it. So we're going to click on joints with filler, filler material, to have different filler material for the weld. And we're going to select the joint. Here we select the this one, the weld part, and we click OK. Then we click add, so we have the weld metal as well. So everything is okay. Here we go to the next step. Here we need to select the process type. General arc is here. We have manual metal arc or GMAW here, MIG and MAG, or GTAW, which is also TIG. We have laser and other processes, so we're going to select manual metal arc. The energy unit should be on joule over millimeter, and the velocity should be millimeter per second. We click on the weld line and we select the path, and we see everything else is automatically selected, but we need to select the filler material here and the welding group, which is this one. Everything else is selected here, and we're going to deal with the weld pool parameter. So I would like to have a speed of 4 mm/s, and the initial time is 0. It automatically understands which time is the end time. If I modify this to 2, you see it takes more time. So 4 is okay for now. And this is the estimated length with in parameters. And what are these? If we click on this image, we see the Golduck double ellipsoid, front ellipsoid, and rear ellipsoid. And the penetration is here said, this is the penetration of the Golduck, and this is the width of the Golduck. And this one is the length of the Golduck ellipsoid. So we can modify these parameters. I would like to say the length of 10 and width of 6 and the penetration of 5. And we're going to modify these numbers if it's not great. And for the energy, I would like to have 800, and the efficiency of manual metal arc is 0.66. if I click on add, we see here the Golduck ellipsoid is created. So I'm going to rotate this. Here is the shape of our weld pool. If we change our parameters, we can see that this is going to be different. So I can rotate it. Maybe better to rotate this like this. Alright, so let's say we're going to have a narrower width like 3. We see that the weld is not, the root of weld is not covered by the weld, so it means it's not enough. We change all of them to 3, and we see here we have a narrower ellipsoid, and which is not good. So we have to select parameters in a way to cover here the root of the weld. So to me, is these numbers are okay. I think we're good for now. If we did the analysis and it was not good, we can do that again. So we go to the next step. We have to define the cooling condition. So we have to click on cooling part and select the heat environment we defined before, the highlighted one, and we say the medium is air cooling, so it's okay for me for now. We don't need to do the forced cooling or anything else, and the ambient is 20 degrees centigrade, so we approve that. And the next step is to apply the cooling conditions, such as the initial time and the final time. So I would say, let's say it's 1000 seconds. This is a very large number, but this is an example. We're not looking forward to compare these values to an article, so we go forward with this one. The next step is to do the clamping option. We click on rigid and select all directions, and from collectors we select the clamp. So we add this, and we have to apply this. This is the clamping condition from the previous step. We click OK, and the time is 1000 seconds. It means that we keep the clamps all the time. So I can add this, and we have the clamping option. We go to the next part. The next part is not crucial, and we did everything, and we're good to do the analysis. We can have the mechanical analysis or thermometallurgical one. We don't need the mechanical analysis because we're not seeking the residual stress. We only want to do the thermal analysis. So we go for thermometallurgical analysis, and we generate input data. As you see, a file is created. It says there's another project here you want to override, because I already did something with this name, and I'm going to click on solve. I have to select this MMAW and thermometallurgical, and I can do the compute. Here we use the solver. mono or DMP, and you can either do the multiprocessors, it based on your your system. The core of my system is 8-core system, so the CPU is 8 cores. I can go up to 8 cores for some of the calculations which are complicated and complex and time consuming, but right now we're okay. Before hitting okay, we have to ensure that in tools and solver setting we should have the path of the solver. I already did that, so you might need to do that yourself. So we click okay, and it's gray, while it's blue means it's doing the calculation, and while it's green, it turns green, it means the calculation is done. So this step is over. We are good to go to the visual viewer to see the results. See you in the next video.